What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and you just saw a quick unboxing on Lenovo's ThinkPad P15 Generation 2 mobile workstation. So what comes inside the box? We have your ThinkPad P15 Generation 2 setup guide. You have your safety and information pamphlet. You have your heavy gauge power cable. And you also have your power adapter, which is about 230 watts. So I'm going to take the power cable and plug it into the power adapter. Awesome. Cool. I'm going to put all the stuff to the side. And last but not least, we have the beautiful Lenovo ThinkPad P15 Generation 2 mobile workstation weighing around 6.50 pounds with a thickness of 1.27 inches. Now, this guy to me is a monster with a lot of ports and features. So if you have the laptop to the point that you are able to open it up like this, on your right hand side, we have one SD card reader and then one 3.2 USB port. On your left hand side, we have a combo audio jack, a nano SIM card slot, one 3.2 USB always on charging, and HDMI port. On the back hand side, we have one RJ45 port or Ethernet port, a power port, two Type-C Thunderbolt ports, and then one Type-C USB port. All right, so we just went over some of the ports and features on the P15 Generation 2. So let's open this guy up real slow. Awesome, look at that beautiful 15.6 OLED display, which we will go over pretty soon. But let's power this guy on. So the power button is actually located right here. So let's press it. Awesome. All right, so the P15 Gen 2 is up and running. Right now, we got the eye going to the left and right because it's looking for my face. You are able to log into this machine using Windows Hello, which is an awesome feature. The ThinkPad P15 also has a fingerprint scanner, which that's the way I'm going to log in right now. So let's go right ahead. Awesome. Okay, so let's start with the trackpad on the P15 Gen 2. The trackpad, if you want to know the measurement of the trackpad, it is around 3.96 inches. That's about one quarter, one nickel, one penny, and two dimes. When I was using the trackpad, I didn't have a lot of issues. It just worked. It was nice. You do have the signature ThinkPad track point in the middle to kind of maneuver the mouse if you want. That's up to you. Most of the time when I was using and testing out the laptop for you guys, I kind of plugged in a USB mouse and I was using it that way. That's the way I like to work with laptops, but the trackpad and the track point is there for you to take advantage of. All right, so let's talk about the full keyboard layout on the P15 Gen 2. It does have the number pad right here on your right hand side. When I was using the keyboard, I did not have any issues at all. It just worked, which was great. You know, ThinkPad keyboards, for me, I just love the way that it responds. It's quick, no issues on that. Now, if you want to know the distance between each key, it's normally between 0.11 to 0.12 inches. Now, this keyboard is backlit, white. It's pretty bright if you're using it at night, which is a great thing. At the top of the keyboard, you're going to get your speakers. This is where the speakers are located. And the highest that I got on these speakers was around 96.7 decibels. Then we have the beautiful 15.6 Ultra HD OLED touchscreen display. Yes, it is touchscreen. I'm not a huge fan with touchscreen monitors, but it is there. With a resolution of 3840 by 2160. Now, the default scaling for this display was around 250%. I do recommend to lower it down between 225 to 200. I think that right now I have it to 225 and it looks good. Now, for nits, this display is 400. For the brightness, I think this is the highest right now for the brightness and this is the lowest. And let's go back up. This is the highest. Refresh rate for the display is only 60 hertz. The machine does support HDR, Windows HD, which is great. Make sure that you have the power adapter plugged in so you're able to turn on the HDR feature and then you're able to take advantage of the OLED when you're watching HDR content. At the very top of the 15.6 inch display, we have a 720p webcam. And with that 720p webcam, it does come with a privacy guard, which I kind of find is super easy to slide it to the left and right to open it and close it. Some of these privacy guards are sometimes too stiff, So you got to really dig in there to open it up. But for this one, I found it super easy to open it and close it with no problem. All right, so we just went over the trackpad, the keyboard, and the 15.6-inch display on the P15 Gen 2 mobile workstation. So let's talk about some of the specifications. Now, on the desktop, I'm going to right-click on the taskbar. Let's go into Task Manager. And within Task Manager, I'm going to click on More Detail. Let's open up this window. Let's go inside Performance. I'm going to right-click on the CPU graph and then go to Change to Logical Processor. Now, this machine is running an 11th Gen Intel Core i9-11950H processor with a clock speed of 2.60 GHz. One socket, 8 cores, 16 logical processors. Oof, that's awesome. Now, for memory, it is housing only 32 gigs. I think the max that you could get is around 128 gigs. Now, for storage, it comes with 1 terabyte solid state drive. And it also comes with 2 graphics cards. The first one is the Intel Ultra HD graphics card, which is part of the processor. And it is also housing an NVIDIA RTX A5000 graphics card with 16 gigs of memory. Now, with these specifications, I was able to do so much with these specifications. I was able to edit 4K video without creating proxies within Adobe Premiere. I was able to edit audio within Audition, as well as make modifications within Camtasia Studios. And I was also able to run multiple programs at the same time without having any delay. Now, for gaming on this machine, I definitely wanted to take advantage of the NVIDIA RTX A5000 graphics card, and playing Black Ops as well as Street Fighter was awesome, especially on the OLED display. The color and the images popped out from the display. It was beautiful. I loved it. Now, for heating, this machine definitely gets hot around this area right here and around the monitor. It does have vents on your right hand, left hand, and on the backhand side, as well as the bottom side. There's a lot of vents to try to keep it nice and cool, but I did notice that it was getting hot around this area as well as the display. All right, so we just went over some of the specifications on the P15 from Lenovo, and this guy is a beast. So let's talk about the battery. Now, for the battery, I ran PC Mark 10, and I ran the test 3 times, and the first one was modern office battery life. It took around 3 hours and 45 minutes. On my second test, I ran pure video, and it lasts around 6 hours and 23. And last but not least, without the power supply, I ran gaming, and it only lasts about 1 hour and 7 minutes. Now, I do recommend having this laptop plugged in if you are gaming, because you want to take full advantage of that RTX graphics card, and you need that extra juice. Now, laptops are great without power, because, you know, you don't want to be plugged in all the time with a laptop. If you're using it for surfing, going online, purchasing stuff, open up a Word document, Excel, this machine is going to last between, I would say, 3-4.5 hours. It all depends on how you use it. Again, this is a program that's constantly running in the background until the battery flushes out, and it dies out around 10 to 5%. So if you tweak the settings and you are able to kind of push it a little bit more, but it all depends on how you use it. Now, due to the graphics card, this machine has 2 modes. It has discrete or hybrid, that you are able to do a Windows I, and within Windows I, go to updates and security. And within updates and security, just go to recovery, and you want to boot inside the advanced setup and get into the BIOS to configure it. Now, the discrete and hybrid allows you to basically just use the RTX card only. Hybrid would allow you to use the Intel and the graphics card. And from my understanding, if you do hybrid, sometimes the battery life is longer rather than just going discrete. I didn't really notice a big change with discrete or hybrid, but for the P15, it is automatically set up to do hybrid, but you are able to get inside BIOS and change it. All right, so let's conclude our unboxing slash review on the P15. So this machine is a beast. Retail price for this machine is around $1,600, and the highest is around $1,800, but it all depends on how you get it configured at the Lenovo site. If you want more memory, bigger hard drive space, and the graphics card, and it also comes in different flavors on the display. Now, for this machine, I reviewed the 15.6 Ultra HD OLED display, but You could also get the full HD model, but again, it's really up to how you configure it at the Lenovo site. It's going to cost a little bit more money. I do recommend having a second hard drive, purchasing a second hard drive for this machine, because on the second hard drive, you're able to install all your programs as well as your gaming files into that second hard drive. Now, the machine is able to support multiple monitors. You do have that HDMI port as well as that two Type-C Thunderbolt 4 ports. Just take advantage of it. Overall performance, it was amazing. I was able to run all my programs at the same time. I'm super excited because this machine has a great graphics card. So stay tuned because I am going to configure this machine to do a little bit of cryptocurrency mining for me. I want to see how big the hash rate is going to be on this particular computer with this graphics card. And overall, hopefully you guys enjoyed this review and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.